Today we'll be showing you how to convert a Behmor 1600 home roaster to a Behmor 1600 Plus model by installing a new control panel. While not a difficult installation, a few common tools are needed, including a number 2 short Phillips screwdriver, a long magnetized one, a pair of wire cutters, and a pair of pliers. We're about to convert the Behmor 1600 roaster into a Plus model just by changing out the control panel. The Plus has more features than the original one had, adding some manual controls and overrides, temperature sensor readouts, drum speed control, Rosetta Stone, and some other nice features. Pretty straightforward to do this changeover, but there's a lot of screws to remove and then later on replace. We have the right side panel, the left side panel, and then the top section. They're all going to come off, and then we're going to get to the control panel itself, replace it, and put everything back in the reverse order. Okay. So let's start out by upending the machine and getting to the bottom. There are 3 screws under here and 3 more along the back. Okay. All right. Running. Okay. So at this point, you want to tap the panel forward because there are some interlocks that have to be released. And then from the inside, you want to disconnect the fan, from the cooling fan, from the board. It's got a little clip to compress and it's out. And now, to make sure you got everything organized, take all the screws that came from that panel, keep it in that section and put that one aside. And let's head to the other side. The other side has 7 screws. Same kind of thing. 3 on the bottom, 3 on the back, and then there's one more inside the door. It's over here. I'll show you in a little bit. Okay. And then there is a 7th screw that's just here inside the door. Put all the screws in the section so you can keep them isolated. And now we're ready to move on to the top. To remove the top section, we're going to start out removing these 4 screws that are along the back. And then we're going to move to the front inside the door, and using that shorter screwdriver with the stubbier point, we're going to remove these 4 up in here too. 1, 2, 3, and 4. So in order to remove the top, you have to straighten out this little pin here so that it can slide through the slot. That's it. Once it's all straight, little retaining arm is straight, T, you can just pull it through and then the top is free. Make a note of this gap. Okay. So now we're going to remove, with a longer and preferably magnetized screwdriver, 3 screws starting at the bottom. This one here, then this one here, and then finally this one at the very top. notice there's a little pin here that this also has to go over from the door. Finally, there's two wires that have to be disconnected. One set of cables has to come out, one connector, and then lastly is this power connector. We're going to have to cut you got to be very careful not to cut any wires while you're doing this. That's off. And then you can pull this connector out, and the old roaster control panel is free. Okay. I'm going to start off doing everything in reverse. Connector. Now we're going to start putting the screws back. Don't forget, this has to go over the door. Okay, at this point, it's a good idea to take a look and make sure everything is lined up properly on the outside, which it appears to be. And this is a good time to test and make sure the electrical connections are working. Okay? All right. Okay. Next, profiles starting with P1 through P5, noting changes on the display. Next, programs A through D. Next, press plus and then minus. You know, noting the increments. And then light, cool. And lastly, off. Everything seems to be working fine. Let's put the rest of it together. All right, we're going to start reassembling, and we're going to take that little T, and we're going to put it into this slot that it's made for. Until it pushes through. And then, once it's there, you can give it a little twist to lock it into place. Now we're going to start putting screws back in the reverse order in which they came out. So I'm going to tip it on its back. We're going to be putting screws, the four screws that came out of the top are going to go back into the top. Up here. Snap that back in place again. Fingers.
Oh, that's fine.